So the first question is, what do we actually do about our financial institutions at this point in time?
We basically need to do as close as we can to reconstructing the regulatory regime that prevented severe financial crises from World War II until the 1980s. So that's the light in which you want to look at it. What can we do to restore that kind of precautionary set of rules in this much more complicated financial environment we've got?
Can we? I mean, explicit in your answer is it's a much more complicated financial environment. We may be no match for the people and institutions that have evolved.
You know, the thing they want to bear in mind is that the financial system relies on a lot of explicit and implicit government backing. And sure, somebody can always in some corner of the financial universe do something that completely eludes all regulation, but if they are not part of the not under the umbrella of government support, they're not going to get a lot of business. So I think it can be done, but it does require a lot of hard thinking, a lot of hard work, and somehow you have to be able to stand up to the influence of money.
George Shultz told us that to shrink financial institutions, all you really need are disincentives, higher capital requirements. The larger the organization is, higher leverage requirements, the bigger it is, and that in itself would pretty much do the trick.
I wouldn't have put it that way. I think there will still be big institutions, and of course we have to bear in mind that it's possible to have a banking crisis even without too big to fail. You can, you know, it was a lot of small banks that collapsed the financial system in the 1930s. But I think that taking institutions that look like there could be systemic risk, you know, they can bring the thing down, and saying they have to hold a lot of capital that they can't leverage themselves, will reduce the incentive for them to shoot for the moon and take big risks, will mean that they're less likely to fail if stuff does go wrong. That's probably the core component of any reform.
So you think that, George Shultz thinks that. Why hasn't it been done?
Well, you know, it's the old line, it's from Upton Sinclair, it's very difficult to get a man to understand something when his salary depends on his not understanding it. In this case, you might say it's very difficult to get a member of Congress to understand something when his campaign contributions depend on his not understanding that. So it really is. This is as raw an instance of the power of money in preventing us from doing something that everybody knows we should do that I've ever seen.
Are we then fated to not be able to accomplish this?
I think if President Obama puts his weight behind it, if there's a real push from, you know, the talking, the chattering classes on this, which obviously has got to include me, that we can get something. It'll probably fall short of what you'd like, but a lot of people, you know, against all of that, there are people who want to leave their mark. I think Barney Frank doesn't want to go down as the czar of finance in the House of Representatives who failed to do anything about the greatest crash since the Great Depression.